Get up there.
I was moved by the old.
Nice shot.
Are you ready now? Are you ready?
Yes.
Please raise your right hand. Repeat after me. I, Sean Kelly.
I, Sean Kelly.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support.
That I will support.
The Constitution of.
The Constitution of.
The United States.
The United States.
And the Constitution of.
The Constitution of.
The State of New Jersey.
The State of New Jersey.
That I will bear true faith.
That I will bear true faith.
And allegiance.
And allegiance.
To the same.
Same.
And to the government.
And to the government.
Established.
Established.
In the United States.
In the United States.
And in this state.
And in this state.
Under the authority.
Under the authority.
Of the people.
Of the people.
And that I will.
And that I will.
Faithfully.
Faithfully.
Impartially.
Impartially.
And justly perform.
And justly perform.
All the duties of.
All the duties of.
Police captain.
Police captain.
Of the Weehawken Department.
Of the Weehawken Department.
Of public safety.
Of public safety.
Under the best of my ability.
Best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
And that I will.
And that I will.
will faithfully.
Faithfully.
And impartially.
Impartially.
And justly perform.
And justly perform.
All the duties of.
All the duties of.
Police captain.
Police captain.
Of the Weehawken Department.
Of the Weehawken Department of Public Safety.
Public Safety.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Yeah.
How long have you been a police officer?
20 years.
20 years?
It's my boy, Bill.
Actually, it's all the senior year. You're on 20.
Thank you. Mr. Devon?
Yes.
Councilman Rodrick?
Yes.
Councilman Spock?
Yes.
Yes. Hearing adoption of ordinance number 5, 2016, temporary access easement. All right, now, this is 2304 Palisade Avenue. This is a requirement easement for a contaminated piece of property where all that can be. And it's been ongoing for 5 or 6 years. Finally, we have a plan to get the easement for under the sidewalk across the street.
So.
Second, and they put it all back where it was. Who's best here? Second, Martino. We now open for hearing discussion of ordinance number 5, 2016, temporary access easement. Do we have anyone here to comment on this easement? Hearing none?
Hearing none.
Close to adopt. Second, second by Martino.
Councilman Sosa? Councilman Strichard?
Yes.
Councilman Martino?
Yes.
Councilman Spock?
Yes.
Okay. Resolution for transfer appropriations. That's our, that's our, here it comes to close. Our motion. Move on, Martino.
Second.
Second, Mr. Spock.
Councilman Sosa? Councilman Strichard?
Yes.
Councilman Martino?
Yes.
Councilman Spock?
Yes.
We have three resolutions that we can send to general on. First is tax reasonable agreement. Second, payment taxes, there is tax exemption for your motion. Second, Martino, roll call, Madam Clerk.
Councilman Sosa? Councilman Strichard?
Yes.
Councilman Martino?
Yes.
Councilman Spock?
Yes.
And also introduction to our salary ordinance, ordinance number 7, 2016. We found some curbs in the salary ordinance, so we recommend that we have a motion. Move Sosa, second, Martino.
Councilman Sosa?
Aye.
Councilman Strichard?
Yes.
Councilman Martino?
Yes.
Councilman Spock?
Yes.
Yes. Moving on, payment bills. Martino.
Second.
Second, Strichard.
Councilman Sosa?
Aye.
Councilman Strichard?
Yes.
Councilman Martino?
Yes.
Councilman Spock?
Yes.
We're going to go with that discussion. We asked our police department to stay for the police discussion on personnel. So we have no other, what are we doing, the ABC hearing?
The 25th.
Is that the 25th? Okay. We have other discussion, nothing else, right? What's that? I know. What's that? Nothing else, okay. Now, we're open for public comment. Anyone here to address the council, come forward, name and address.
Thank you very much for cleaning up the yard. I'm glad you did this much improvement. It was really awful. And I was going to hear about, I really support the work of Kirk Stone, and I commend the work he did in helping them do better and helping residents there. So I appreciate that. Thank you. I just wanted to question, was 603 Bridge sold, or is it going to be up for sale?
Our understanding is sold.
It's sold.
Right, so all the liens have been paid off, and all the back taxes have been paid.
So my question is, when the city takes over a property that's been abandoned, and it's condemned, goes through that process, how does someone in the neighborhood find out?
We didn't have to take over the property. What we, our strategy has been when somebody's vacant property is that we're going to go through the combination process. And by doing that, you'd be surprised how many people wind up coming forward. But remember I said at the last meeting, or one of the meetings, you can own a property. You don't want to take responsibility for it, but you still pay your taxes to a third party. And the third party does not disclose to the owners. So a lot of these properties, the taxes are paid up, but they weren't taken care of, so we had extra means to pay. So on this one, we didn't have to go through the full combination. And on 591?
592.
By 592, I think we're in the process of moving forward.
Right, you said that last time.
Now, maybe someone will come forward, now, if no one comes forward, then we take the property, and I think we, it's a four process, I think, that we go through the court.
How do you find out?
Once you take the property, we have to forward for sale.
Not very well. I mean, it could be a combination, but the.
Our goal would be to put it on sale, and so it comes home for public auction. And anything, it's amazing.
Yeah.
Did they basically have a purple set? It's amazing, it's got me thinking, right?
And they are, it's weird, yeah. And I have another question, just out of curiosity, I've heard recently about a resolution that was passed in Union City about short-term rentals. And I was wondering if Weehawken had a position on short-term rentals or Airbnbs or something?
Well, we are currently in discussions, we are enforcing Airbnbs as we find out on property under our ordinance, sort of very extensive boarding house ordinance.
Okay.
And so we looked at it, I don't think we need a new ordinance, but in effect, we're going to consider boarding house. And we've closed down several boarding houses, I mean, occasionally someone licenses a property, tries to open up a boarding house. There was one in Highland Avenue, there was one in Great Avenue over the years. So we're handling into that and being rather successful. So it's very difficult to catch people. But usually in Weehawken, people are not asked to say, I think the house across the street has a lot of people coming and going. So that's, you know, if you go on the internet, you find out if somebody goes on some of the Airbnb, and we're monitoring it, and we'll send out notices, we have a few more that we're going to trace in.
So I have a question, the boarding house ordinance, is that, like, there's one thing where somebody buys a property and they run, you know, they just have people coming in, it's like an open hotel. And then there's a thing where a homeowner rents a room in their house. Is that called in a boarding house, or is that separate?
It could, but it's very hard to catch when somebody's living there and rents out a room.
I think you should be able to do that, so that's good.
Well, no, but you know, if you've got somebody, that actually lives in the apartment, and rents out a room, it's kind of hard to enforce because of friends or whatever, and they're living there. You know, the biggest problem here is not anything owner occupied. It's owner unoccupied.
That's true.
It's abandoned property, you know, the best landlords in the world have trouble sometimes keeping up with their properties, they don't see it that much. So that's what we focus on, the owner unoccupied, that's it. So what happened in the apartment, somebody rents an apartment, they have three bedrooms, and they rent to three separate people. That's a different story.
Right.
Right, that falls under a variety of things, fire codes, especially in that one, two, three, four houses. Fire codes and gun, boarding house.
Good, so we have basically the boarding house ordinance, that's against boarding houses, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
We're against illegal boarding houses. If somebody wants an illegal boarding house, they have to go before one of the town boards, the planning board, the board of justice. And it's probably fair to say it'd be a very difficult application because there's so many requirements you have to meet. We do have, I believe, three existing boarding houses. We've closed down the biggest ones. But the three existing ones are small. They come here every year. They have an application. We review the health for any health violations, for any criminal activity, for any fire violations. The township attorney agrees that it's a very strict policy. So we've gone from about, I think, over the last 25 years, 30 years, from 9 or 10 down to 3. They're all owner occupied. All three we have left owner occupied. From the old days when this was a railroad port area. The biggest ones we closed was, it was 146th Street that had 44 units. It was horrible. And then the old Park Avenue Hotel, that's not a senior building, was a semi boarding house, block house, or whatever. So they're gone. But we close a lot. And every time I have a location, go on one, can't say that, just want to say, on High Point Avenue, operating as a boarding house, basically the first one, second one. And that was about 4 or 5 or 6 years ago, we closed it down. Then we had to close it down a second time, then they finally sold.
Great, thank you so much.
Anyone else?
Good evening, all. My name is Richard Saunders. I spoke at the last meeting yet. I want to first say thank you. I saw just today that the up top, the crosswalk was painted and that extension was put in.
This one did.
Next one.
Yeah, I had to do some rain, so that's why they got it.
Good, I want to say thank you. That makes me different from my call. I've got several other problems that may cause more problems than last week's. Let's start with this. I walked again up the shipping steps last time to take photos of the top of those steps that still have some light. It's been a month now, and no one it's possible to get up and take a look, it might just be like a hole that's out there.
We have it on the list.
There's no one?
It's on the list.
Same list. Showing both these are both taken with the natural light that's there, so that's what you're looking at.
Okay.
You're shot on a tripod, so what you see is what you get when you walk down the stairs.
Both of these are on the list. I think these stairs all the time, and usually it's a little worse now with better trees.
Yeah, we saw that light before. There is one light that hangs over the trees, which is never run, but it's been hidden by the trees. If it were fixed, it's still there.
Yeah, we both. It's on the list.
All right.
We have several lights. Some lights are all over town. Some people list some, most of them BCG. We can't touch them with BCG. So they have to wait for them to get caught up. And the last 2 weeks, there's a lot of time lost. Not a lot of stuff is done when it's raining.
Yeah, great. The next one is probably going to be a larger problem. Gus Nassis, who lives down the street from us. This is a picture of his house. It's about 8 feet.
You don't have to show us anything.
I'd like to because I want to see why this is.
We are not. We are not going to need any pictures. We are not going to need any pictures from Mr. Nassis. Ask the question.
How do we get something done?
Ask the question.
When will something be completed?
We have no idea. We have been working with Mr. Nassis for 10 years. So you can get the judges to agree on a crackdown. We've been working for 10 years.
But we still have your daily. We can't keep them off this property for.
We are in multiple lawsuits with him. He's suing the town, he's suing him.
I realize there are some people in the
neighborhood. I realize.
Own property here, I have to deal with.
But you might hear it, did you hear what I just said?
I really don't know.
No, this is what I said. For 10 years, we've been in court with him. For 10 years, he's now suing us and we're suing him. All right? If it was simple to do, it would be done. So it's a detriment to the entire neighborhood, which is our case before the courts. However, the courts are very lenient, and they give him enormous amounts of time on his property situation. It's very, very.
But if you can get off his property, how about the sidewalk?
It's not, isn't that? Everything's in part. We are all being sued individually by Mr. Nassis, okay?
Okay.
That's so. It's easy to say it should be fixed. It's very difficult to get it fixed. And it's been a.
I realize it's a place. I'm not sure about the sidewalk.
It's been a thorn in our side for many, many years.
So that's one. Another one, I had last time showed some photographs of Long Beach and the steps of the garbage that's on that. Again, I walk my dog twice a day. I think I have a little dog now. So once again, that was a month since last I was here. The garbage is not complete. And I see four guys sleeping in one of the yellow trucks about 50 feet from that steps. I also found guys down behind the St. Lawrence Church sleeping in their trucks. I want to know if there's something going on in this town that someone has to show some responsibility. All these signs, I was down at the field today, my daughter's playing baseball right now. None of the doors open going into the field for 2 years now. I asked them.
Stop. What doors go?
On the turf field. On the field next to it and all of your tennis courts.
What are you talking about? Well, people use them all the time.
I'm not saying that I'm open. Well, my kid is having the kids fight with them to get into the thing. They don't open right
now. Which doors?
See, doors are my shadow.
That's the photos.
Yeah,
I don't know what you're talking about. And I want to say this for the record.
Yep.
Our DPW is extremely hardworking. Okay. And maybe they're on break, or maybe they're on lunch. And I don't think the individual should be going around accusing DPW workers of not doing the job. Now, if you want to know about the cleanup of the steps, since it is on a steep slope, those steps, a very steep slope, the township administrator has made arrangements to have them clean. A combination of our personnel and people who go up there have the proper insurance for them in case somebody falls. So don't assume it's not being done. And not everything's going to be done on your time frame. There's a lot of things to be done. But let's not have the public think that our DPW employees are sleeping on the job.
That's exactly what
happened. Because you want to go out in all kinds of weather and all kinds of things, and if you have an individual employee you're thinking, or you know the truck, you can relay that to the township manager, and we will question that.
Full force,
Mars is not the
end of the day.
Mars is not the township manager. And sometimes, given the conditions of the weather, they They may be rest.
I'm talking today, I'm here with very, with very busy.
Maybe now, let's not assume.
There's no something, have you heard of it?
I don't know, it's not the point.
In the morning, people don't come here in their sweatpants to clock in and then go back home. Why is that?
Who?
One of the guys that drives the safety bureau truck, number 275, he's there every morning in sweatpants.
There's nobody that goes in sweatpants. Maybe they go for another building in town, do you ever think of that? How do you know they're going home?
Because he's in his sweatpants.
How come, maybe he works in sweatpants? You can't assume he's going home.
I've lived here for a long time.
And you always.
I've seen a lot of stuff.
Last time we ignored some of the comments you wrote about the council being irresponsible and not paying attention. We are very proud of our public works employees. There are times when circumstances may allow them to not be moving all the time. And I'm not having anybody sit up here and disparage them. That's wrong, they're very hardworking, in all kinds of weather, in all kinds of conditions, doing all kinds of things. It's easy to go around and pick on people, but that doesn't mean they're not doing their job. And secondly, we would not send them along the steep slope to clean up on their own, because we are not insured for it. So we have made arrangements, as I said, for the township manager to insure people, okay?
Absolutely. Now, another question.
But if you do have a need for a person, just give it to the township manager.
I've spoken to him, I decided I need to go to here. So this is the H. Ross building, and.
We're down in the picture, we're familiar with H. Ross.
Sorry.
In case you don't think you are familiar with it.
No, I'm sure you are, but you're on, I'm standing here, I've lived in the house, and now I have a dozen trucks parked in front of my house every day. Now, this has become a de facto parking lot, and I don't know what it is to deal with, it's always been, but. So I'm just gonna follow them trucks, I think, it's your trucks being driven, your people being driven.
You have brought this to the attention for a long time. And I think even a moment ago, Mr. Ross wrote a letter to you explaining.
That's me, I'm here, well, thank you.
Somebody else. Was a letter, we wrote a letter at one time, criticized, and he wrote a response.
Okay.
And in response, though, people live next to schools, there's gonna be school children. People live next to parks, there's gonna be noise. You live next to me, right across from the township, DPW garage. It's neat, it's orderly. Are the trucks parked in the street?
Yes. No, I understand, Your Honor, that there will be parking, you're not talking about the details. They park in front of my driveway, and they leave it there, which I have trouble getting out, and say, why don't we have a place now in the tracks to park?
Because we don't own a place now near the tracks to park. We made arrangements for the dump trucks to park there. And they should be parked from the driveway, we will remind them. I think, though, that you're pretty good at not parking.
No, they're just parked, they're parking right at my driveway. So when I look at my window, when I have these come over, I'm gonna DPW yellow truck right in front of my house, essentially. I don't like that, I'm sure you wouldn't like it.
I wouldn't mind at all. It wouldn't bother me at all.
My best brother, there's a truck that you got, it's a tank truck, that I think goes back to the bird trap on that street. From what I understand, speaking to this company, they got $3,000 for that truck for one day, clean.
No, it's not one day. You spoke to some of your companies who are paying $3,000 a day, you spoke to the wrong company, the wrong person. We do not spend $3,000 a day. We don't place $3,000 a day for our police department.
Why is it that you're paying that kind of money, you rent something around?
We're not paying that kind of money.
We're not?
We're not paying $3,000 a day.
What will it pay for?
I have no idea what I'm talking about. It's not $3,000 a day.
Okay, but that's something that they all have. I called them because after walking my dog out there, there is no window in that truck, in the pump truck. After 3 weeks of it sitting there, it never moved. And the passenger side window is down, nobody cared. I made a call to the company and said, you guys, you've rented the truck to Weehawken, there's no window in it. It's been raining and there's nobody care. The next day, it was filled up in plastic. But again, it's been for 3 weeks, so I think it was used for open day to make sure the bird water was not thrown up there. And I wonder why.
I have no idea, you're right.
Okay. But here, one of the things that I would like to have someone pass on that are a whole lot cheaper than renting a tank truck. I mean, get my degree.
They looked at everything, and I believe they think this is the best vehicle to do it for now. They are,
Nobody told me also that we weren't allowed to sluice that subwater, we told me it was hazardous waste, and had to bring an outside contractor to clean that up. That's not what happened, so.
Obviously, I don't believe you told us, so I said, you misunderstood. I think you misunderstood. You do not like the Department of Public Works, we've known that for several years. But you have to quote people accurately, okay?
Out of the field, the fences are all broken on the diamonds. So I asked someone, why are these fences? It's been a couple of years in it like this. When I asked the person, they said, that's DPW. I said, no, you got six people sitting in this room today, I asked them. I said, does anyone tell, anyone?
What fences are broken?
Just explain it to you, did.
No, you didn't explain, you were right. What fences are broken?
On each of the diamonds, the place where the players come in, into the dugout, there's fences, you know, they're going to the dugout, right, on either side of each fence. All those broken, they've all been.
I say, why don't we have them all done? You're wrong. We just had a major turn, I don't see any picture.
I saw them today, so you're getting.
I go in and out of them all done.
There's one today.
No, does the fence work?
They work.
You said they don't.
It's not safe, there's one of the balls from flying, they're not safe, but again, we have the same problem.
I'm going to end this now. We're not going to go on picking on DPW.
Okay.
No one down there has a problem with those gates. They're fine. You may think they're wrong, no one else. We just had a tournament with teams from all over North Jersey who praised our facility. So, and some
pages of things that were wrong in this town, they've been wrong for 7 years, many of them. And telling me that that's not an oversight problem, there's not a problem with some of them.
So, what's the question?
I'm not someone who walks down the street, sees these things, and says, gee, that fence is broken. That's just someone thinks that. Why would that be?
Maybe they don't care about you. Maybe.
You should care about the crosswalk.
We're going to end this now. We're going to end this now. You are, it's easy to point out something. No one down there, I've done it for 2 weekends, thinks there's anything wrong with those gates, okay? Everything functions as supposed to, everything's fine. Let me finish. We know you have a problem with a lot of the way things are. That's your choice. That's your right. So we're going to end this, everybody does. Discussion now, okay? Because it's easy to look at some small things that aren't done and not see the big picture of everything that is done.
That's not how you look at it.
All right. Oh, one more statement, and then we gave a lot of time, more than normal, finish.
So you're almost speaking over it. I'm having an investigation on this.
You can take a second if you want.
Thank you.
And you can open anything you want. You don't have to worry about that. But for the record, and for that record, we have a phenomenal Department of Public Works.
You can say what you want.
That we're all very proud of. We don't want anybody to just.
I will continue taking photos of them sitting in their trucks all day long.
They don't know us that. You're just wrong.
There is zero responsibility.
Thank you for coming out. Some of the things you brought to our attention, you were right, we fixed. Other things we think you're wrong, and we think you're going to adjust that. I'm not going to wait till I just finish. Okay? Are we done? We're done. Thank you.
Go next time.
We have problems with all kinds of things. With people that don't pick up after the dogs. With people that don't walk dogs on leash.
Those are personal safety issues. You know, lights on a staircase is a safety issue.
And people worry about pigeons.
You can't say it on
the door. People directly worry about pigeon droppings, and people don't worry about dog droppings. We have all kinds of things to worry about in this town. And DPW does it all.
When do you expect to have a light on the stairways on these two, which are unsafe?
When PSCG can get you.
That's not PSCG, it's a Weehawken light. It's the top of the staircase.
I think it's a PSCG light.
It is not.
Then we will check.
Okay, and I'm assuming that the gentleman next to you is an attorney. Now you're acting as an attorney for the town, and.
You asked me a question, I want to answer.
Okay, but I just want to make sure that this is all getting to someone who knows what can happen.
That can happen anyplace. We spend a lot of time fixing things. Not everything can be fixed. You have
Thank you.
And I said that for your record. We have a great DPW department. And anybody can find something for me anytime. Does anyone else care to address us in anything?
I have something small. Really small. The judge saw me out with the record. Yes, we're in the boat bar. Yes, we're in the boat bar. Who is the, yes, we're in the boat bar.
Yes, we're. It's our, it's a public boat bar, paid for and operated by them.
The water has been contaminated for a while, the boat's getting sick. And so they shut it off.
The water being contaminated, you're talking about?
They shut off the water at the boat bar. They have like a stone on the floor with dogs, and they have a club, humans.
Oh, you mean the water was like covered in the...
They shut it off because people, dogs getting contaminated, they would take them to the vet, GI infections,
That's not the water. What is it?
What is it?
Give your name back, so we can answer Ms. Strickland.
Hi, my name is Fulton. We take our dog here. What it is that the dog, the water runs. There's nothing wrong with the water. The dogs play, they put the dirty paws, and the thing gets clogged in the hair. So because the dogs play, and nobody cleans it, the building, but it's hard to clean it, you have to bring your own water.
So I think the issue is the water that was there, that they're going to clean out the, my understanding is...
They shut it off.
They shut it off because it gets clogged in the hair.
It would probably mean the trap.
Right.
So then, when did they shut it?
They shut it, they open it, I bring water, I think they had it.
The only time I ask is because I think the dog are all blind, and the people that leave dogs there are under the assumption that the town is not doing it. So that's why I wanted to find out.
Have you heard any complaints?
No, they all know that it's the dogs.
All I get is comments, but the issue is, I think they turned the water on occasionally.
Yes.
And we're trying to come up with a system. The issue is not that there's something wrong with water. The issue is they have to run it more frequently to wash out.
It's the dog here, it's clogging the filter.
So they're trying to come up with a system.
Yes, sir.
I understand.
No, I want to be able to tell, when I go down there, I want to be able to tell.
What?
It's yes, sir.
It's not the water, it's a...
It's run by the estuary, but there's a problem with the water. So we heard it was a problem, not with the water. I didn't know it was because of the clogged hair. Because if they don't run it enough, it doesn't wash itself through. And so then you have residual stuff from the dogs using it.
Right.
So we're working with them on come up with a better system so you can run the water more frequently. The water's fine.
You know, the water's fine. I just want to make sure you know, because when I go, you know, I want to hear town's not doing anything. If the town, if it's not the town responsible, you know what I'm saying? I want to be able to say...
It's not fair to say that it's not our total responsibility.
Well, the estuary takes care of it. The town is trying to be in help. Right? Okay, that's what I want to know. I want to tell people something that's not...
They don't have to think it's water.
Well, that's right now, they put a sign saying water is contaminated.
That's the people.
No, the people put the sign.
The people decide, not the building.
So when you talk to people think it's the water, it's the lack of water. The issue is the lack of water.
No, but you don't let them wash it with...
Yeah, and I don't know why it's not running, but what I'm saying is we're trying to get them to run the water more frequently to wash it out. And, you know...
They run it constantly drains, I think it's not that...
Well, I think that's what we're trying to get them to fix, okay?
Yeah, the signs are being counted, you know, it's not, it's the people.
Oh, what?
You know, the people...
So I put up...
And water, they put the drink water.
I was obviously saying that. Like I said, I just want to make sure.
The water's fine, but they have to clean. They have to get the water.
I go...
Because I think they do it a few times a day now. But we're trying to get them to do it, especially in hot weather, more frequently.
I don't know what to do. 9:30, 10 o'clock at night.
They shut it down, right?
Well, they do.
Yeah, I bring water.
So you know, we gotta find out the last time they went. They may shut it down to work. What we're finding out, multiple towns, we're finding out that if you don't flush the whole park regularly, things build up. And that's what we're finding out. And a lot of towns have the same problem now. And the dog will catch an illness from another dog.
Well, that's...
So we're trying to get them to flush more.
There were a few people down there, followed the town, and the town needs water, and my friend goes along with the town hall. Well, if it's not, the
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you a lot. Anyone else? Hopefully a quick one. C. Brancher, evening. I learned that the Union City Board of Commissioners discussed the bus shelter at High Point and Palisade. And they were talking about southwest corner, which is obviously the Union City side. And then from input from Larry Price, they decided southeast corner, which of course is where we are, inside the corner of the reservoir. I just wanted to ask if that's been discussed on the Weehawken side. Is that against co-ownership between Union City and Weehawken?
I mean, that's something in regards to just the bus stop.
The bus stop, no,
okay.
We have to work where, you know.
Okay.
So this kind of interest transfer normally asks us about a shelter.
Right.
Generally, we don't put them up.
Is the area already paying for something like that?
I'm sorry.
Does Port Authority pay for a bus shelter or the town?
That's not normal for us. The gentleman's complaining with Mr. Nass's look like nothing. But we were reluctant to put them up because they did damage greatly. There were tremendous nuisance over time. But I think in that location, you probably get away with it because it's wide sidewalk to start with. And it's very visible, but they really, we've had them from time to time over town. And they get damaged, they get graffiti, they look terrible after a while. And the neighbors are saying, take it down, it's destroying it. Since that's kind of about the normal area of Transfer Street, if we got a request, we would consider it.
Okay, thank you.
Anyone else? All right, motion to executive session.
Move that the special approval of the meeting and move forward to executive session.
Move that second by Deputy Mayor Sosa, second by Councilman Zakon, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Purpose of litigation.